Hello, my name is Landon Newman, and today I'm going to talk about how to calculate bulk density, porosity, gravimetric, and volumetric water content. And so to begin, here is a soil sample which we're going to use to calculate bulk density, porosity, gravimetric, and volumetric water content. So here we have a cylindrical soil sample with a diameter of 4.00 centimeters and a height of 12.00 centimeters that weighs 250.0 grams. The sample is then oven dry at 105 Celsius for 40 hours, reaching a final weight of 175.5 grams. First, we're going to calculate bulk density. The definition of bulk density is mass of oven dried soil solids per unit volume of soil. So because of that, we're going to need various information from the soil sample, including height, diameter, wet weight, and dry weight. We also need to calculate volume. If you remember correctly, the equation of volume is height times pi times radius squared. So that will take the height times pi times the diameter divided by 2, which gives the radius, square that, and that gives us 150.796 centimeters cubed. So to calculate bulk density, we take the dry weight divided by the volume, which gives us 1.164 grams per centimeters cubed, which gives us 1.16 grams per centimeters cubed when we take into consideration significant figures. Next, we're going to calculate porosity. The equation of porosity is 1 minus bulk density divided by particle density. And so because of that, we need the bulk density from our previous calculation, which equals 1.164 grams per centimeters cubed. We're using the unrounded answer because we want to minimize rounding error. In addition, we also need particle density. We weren't given that. And so because of that, we are assuming the particle density is 2.65 grams per centimeters cubed. And this is the standard number that we use when we aren't given particle density for calculating porosity. And so to calculate porosity, it's 1 minus the bulk density divided by the particle density, which then gives us 0.5608 centimeters cubed per centimeters cubed, which equals 0.561 centimeters cubed per centimeters cubed. And so as you can see, porosity is typically could be considered unitless. However, we typically present porosity in centimeters cubed per centimeters cubed. Next, we're going to calculate gravimetric water content. The definition of gravimetric water content is mass of water per unit mass of oven-dried soil particles. So because of that, we're going to need information from the soil sample, including the wet weight and dry weight. And so to calculate gravimetric water content, we take the wet weight of the soil minus the dry weight divided by the dry weight, which gives us 0.42450 grams per grams, which equals 0.42450 grams per grams. Again, gravimetric water content could be unitless, but we typically present it in grams per grams. And then finally, we're going to calculate volumetric water content. The definition of volumetric water content is volume of water per unit volume of soil. So because of that, we're going to need gravimetric water content, bulk density, and the density of water. We use the previously calculated gravimetric water content and bulk density for this calculation. However, we aren't given density of water. And so because of that, when you aren't given density of water, you assume the density of water is 1.00 grams per centimeters cubed. So the equation for volumetric water content is gravimetric water content times bulk density divided by density of water. And so to calculate volumetric water content, we simply take the gravimetric water content times bulk density divided by density of water, which gives 0.4941 centimeters cubed per centimeters cubed. And then when you can take into consideration significant figures, that gives us 0.494 centimeters cubed per centimeters cubed. Again, volumetric water content could be unitless, but we typically present it in centimeters cubed per centimeters cubed. And so with that, that is how you calculate bulk density, porosity, gravimetric, and volumetric water content. I'd like to thank you for taking time to watch this video and hope you learned how to perform these calculations better for your own needs.